Shalom, brothers and sisters, once again, it's the voice of Brother Tyler Duck coming to the Spirit, the Most High in Christ. For the record, I would like to reserve my rights according to the Creator of the universe. This is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. This is for educational, informational, and entertainment purposes only. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent attorney. Please be advised. This is part two of what should be a two-part video. Objection to facts, not in evidence, I like to call it. So, if you haven't watched video one, again, go back and watch video one. Now, whenever a lawyer, I was explaining how whenever a lawyer, a counsel, or esquire gives facts that are not listed in evidence, you must stand up or you must object immediately. Now, a lawyer's version of the facts is by itself inadmissible. It's inadmissible. Make no mistake about it. Inadmissible and will actually be excluded by a good judge if you object. You must object. Now, it is your job to require the opponent's lawyer to prove his client's rights to win by presenting admissible evidence. That's your job. And admissible evidence only. Admissible evidence only. So if the lawyer does not otherwise present admissible evidence, you must object. Object. So, if you do not control the lawyer on the other side, the lawyer will do whatever he can to win his case. Make no mistake about it. And most judges will allow it. You could best believe it. You would best believe it because they all work for the bar. They're all in cahoots. So if you don't object, he will use this. He will use these tactics. So you must object, brothers and sisters. Now, don't trust the lawyer on the other side, no matter what or how clean he may seem or how well-dressed he may appear to be, how clean-cut he may be, how honest he may seem. Don't trust the lawyer on the other side. There's a good reason, brothers and sisters, that I say this. Why do you think there's so many jokes about lawyers than there are any other profession, basically? Because too many lawyers are outright crooks. Yeah, I said it. Tyler Duck, so you can know who said it. Most lawyers are crooks. Too many. Now, eagerly, willingly, they will twist the law at every opportunity that they get if you allow them. Now, I know most of you are not going to like this, that's practicing this law, but it's the truth. And brothers and sisters, don't expect the judge to control the opposing party's lawyer for you. You can't expect this. He won't, in most cases. It isn't the judge's job. He's responsible to rule on the objection. But he cannot rule if you do not object. Do you follow me? Do you understand? So it's up to you, brothers and sisters. So object, and if necessary, renew your objections. You understand what I'm saying to you? So if the court refuses to rule, move the court to do so. If the court refuses to rule on that, move the court to do so. And if it doesn't work, object once again. And make certain that the court reporter is getting everything. Make sure it's a court of law. If it's not a court of law, you hire a court reporter and you take one to court with you. Good court reporter. That'll make it a court of law. A court of record, should I say. If it's not a court of record, then you hire your own court reporter and take one with you. Because many of these don't have court reporters in them. So you have to act when you enter. Is this a court of record? And if that doesn't work, check once again. And make certain that the court reporter is getting everything, brothers and sisters. If you have a lawyer, don't trust him. Don't trust your lawyer. Now, I hate to talk to you this way, but you know me. I'm going to give you the truth. And if you don't know me by now, you will know me. I'm going to give you the truth. If you have a lawyer, don't trust him to object when he needs to. Because your lawyer, he works for the bar also. So many lawyers will not object simply because they do not want to upset the judge. But we're not concerned. Are we really concerned about the judge's feelings? Don't you want to be a winner? So you must go the extra mile and make certain. Command your own lawyer, if you have one, if you're naive enough to take one, if you're the defendant, command him, if you have one, and don't pay for services that you're not getting. Stop paying for services that you're not getting, brothers and sisters. If the lawyer won't object, if you're sitting down, stand up to your feet and say, Your Honor, I just fired my lawyer, and I object to facts, not in evidence. When an objection is due, make it. And get the judge to rule on it. Once again, my name is Brother Tyler Doc. And I just wanted to put you up on this, on how to object to facts that are not in evidence. It is essential, brothers and sisters, that you do so. Object to the facts, not in evidence. Shalom.